As it sits, it's kind of a limited platform, and I think there are three things that you need to look out for before you spend all the money trying to modify this thing. So I've drifted this Razor ground force drifter for quite a while now, and there are a few things that you should consider before you also build one of these platforms, because I don't think that there's a lot of people who have built these to this amount of power trying to utilize as much stock parts as possible. Reason being, you know, a lot of people will chop the frame, add on to it, or extend it. And I tried to make it as simple as possible by leaving everything the way it was for anybody who isn't able to chop their frame and weld and do a bunch of extensive mods. With that being in mind, I think the Razor ground force drifter has potential to be an even better platform if you have the ability to weld onto it. But as it sits, it's kind of a limited platform, and I think there are three things that you need to look out for and just be aware of before you spend all the money trying to modify this thing. In some cases, it seems like a great platform. It's basically just a go-kart on a much smaller scale. With how go-karts are being made today, that there are more possibilities, because when the Razor ground force drifter came out, there really wasn't a lot of options on the market. Today, there's, you know, the 9-bot go-kart, 9-bot go-kart pro, the pro 2, and then you also have some hoverboard options. But the thing about those chassis is that they actually extend to fit a bigger person. So the first thing being, this isn't a big person friendly go-kart. So if you're building this for your kid, great. The reason I got into this platform was because I thought it was going to hold up to the standards of my original drift go-kart, which are two completely different platforms. First of all, one's gas and one's electric, this one being the electric one. Second of all, the wheelbase is much shorter in every direction on this go-kart. It didn't drive the way I expected it to because of that. For the amount of power you can fit on this, and for the size, that this is an amazing platform to start out. You can put go-kart wheels on it, as you can see. But the main thing is, for someone who's 5'11", yes, I'll admit it, I'm not 6 foot, it's very tough and it's very awkward to fit on. So, you know, a bigger platform is going to be, it's going to be more convenient. That's the number one reason, is size does matter at the end of the day, no matter what they tell you, boy. Okay, so the second thing is going to be the limited power. It turns back to the first issue, where size is an issue, because the battery is right at your crotch, but then the 72 volt battery probably isn't big enough. This is my 60 volt battery, which just fits fine. You can do a bigger battery and then come onto the other side of the frame, but then you gotta relocate the controller and mount it up maybe on top of the motor or something. Size of motor you can run, this is a 60 volt. I know you can go up to like 72. The motor size isn't an issue, it barely fits when you do the axle flip mod. If you wanted to do like a gas motor, you would have to cut the frame and weld it, like I said earlier. Because of the size, there's a power limitation to what this go-kart's capable of, and then you want more power for someone who's a bigger frame, so it all depends. So the third thing that my problem is with this go-kart is actually the design flaw. Not only is the size tough, or is it tough to fit the proper amount of power to support someone who's a bigger person, you know, the rear end is fine, the axle is fine, the bearings are fine, the motor mount is fine, the brakes are okay, they could be better. The front end seems to have the biggest flaws, that being the spindle design is poor, the OEM spindles suck because they're super weak, and I think it's partially due to a lot of weight being on the front end. Also, the design isn't the best, and they can't mount any other bigger tires. Also, if you want to adapt bigger spindles, you have to do a bunch of hardware. You know, I've tried to put different spindles and adapters onto it to make it as functional as possible, and I just can't seem to get the steering to work the way I like, lead to really flimsy mounted spindles, which is just getting super worn out over time, and they just don't hold up. The mounts, or the frame mount on the go-kart, is very poor, and it's not a easy design to work with, and you have to use like special spindles that have like a C clamp versus ones that fit into a C clamp on the frame. It makes it really tough off the steering shaft because it's very difficult to get some sort of adapter to run two tie rods, because the two tie rods and extending the length off the steering shaft is what's gonna give you more angle. The mount that I made is very weak. It's held up okay, but not to the standard that I want to have. It's really tough to steer, it feels really heavy, it's not ideal, and I think there are better designs out there. Every time that I've driven it, it seems that I have to kind of like force the steering into certain directions instead of it being really free flowing. So just to recap for you guys, my top three problems with the RZR Ground Force Drifter as a suitable drift platform. Number one being size does matter. You are limited by the amount of space that you have and comfortability. The second thing being, because of the size, the limitations on what kind of power plants you can put in this thing. Limited size for the battery. You can't do a gas option unless you cut and weld the frame. So if you have access to that, maybe you could still use this as a platform. And then number three is the design flaws. Nothing too bad with the rear end, but at the same time, the brakes, we would like to have hydraulic brakes instead of cable driven brakes. And we would like to add a bigger sprocket, but we're also limited by the amount of clearance we have in the back. After that, our main problem is the front, with the steering just not cooperating and being really tough to design, and it leads to you spending a lot more money than you would like to on this project, which is something I encountered, and I want to save you guys from that. If this is a platform you're looking to build, just know that the front end is going to require more money and time to redesign and get it really figured out. So with that being said, yes, I'm going to be tearing this go-kart apart, using the parts for my other projects and potential new projects. So be sure to subscribe, stick around for that. If you guys have any questions about building one of these, or if you have one, let me know. I have a comment down below for anyone who has questions and is looking for support. I also have a full playlist in the top right corner for you guys, so you guys can click on that and watch this build from start to finish. It was pretty cool and I enjoyed it. I don't want to steer anyone away from it, but this go-kart is just limited for what I want to do, so we're going to be moving on to something else. I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.